Right, I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to name it after the original fire gym leader from the original games, and I'm going to call it Blaine. Being a female Charmander, I would have probably called it after Charizard turned up in the series called Charla. But it's not, so I like it. Back to my love in Yellow Town by the power of cutscene. Could be a montage, but there's no music for it. Looking for a laugh. I'm ready to help you now, but yeah, we haven't already been helping you anyhow, but... You should train to be a Pokemon Master. The challenge in the league, then it's 8 gyms. Okay, it's all my life, and now I'll make my dreams come true. Right. One last request. East of the central city lies Marfany Lake. Professor Oak, the original professor, is at the lake, and I urgently need you to speak with him. Can I ask you to get him to contact me? So you know where he is, but that wasn't good enough to be able to get a message to him when you found out. Good. You're working at full steam. I'm sorry, full steam? Are you secretly working for Team Steam? Because you're sounding a little dodgy there. Just saying. And the best research centers in the zoo, you know? This is the one of the reasons I do like playing Pokemon hack games. And that is just entirely new places to look around and explore. As opposed to the official games where... Yes, they're new when they first come out, but after that, any playthroughs are effectively redone. Just going back over old land. It's hat games are to a penny at the moment, it seems, and that means there's plenty of places to play through and explore. And with the amount of time it can take to complete a game, I can keep you going for quite a long time. Come on, quick look and attack first. More often than others about the item. Use it to win many battles. Right, thank you. Grass type Pokemon. They're always strong and cute, ready for any battle. Sure they are. I admit some of them are strong, some of them are cute. The amount of them that are a combination of the two at the same time, I'm less sure of, to be honest. They probably are, but they tend to be contradictory in terms. Hey, you look like you're trying to take this gift for your journey. Ooh, max potion. Cover any HP your Pokemon uses in battle. That's not bad. It is a bit powerful for a Pokemon that can be healed completely with a single potion at this point in the game. I'm not going to complain. Some Pokemon only evolve with the help of items, like evolutionary stones. Take one so you can evolve any Pokemon you want. Ooh, got a Thunderstone. Use to evolve certain electric Pokemon. Well, if and when I get an electric Pokemon, I'll know what I, need. There's a show about Pokemon on TV. I learned that fire Pokemon are strong against grass types, but have a weakness to water types, which in turn have a weakness to grass. Yep. And that's why the circle of Pokemon for starters is fire, water, grass. Also because they tend to cover a wider range of weaknesses in the other types as well, which when you have to choose a Pokemon for your starter gives you a bit of a gives you a slight bit of an advantage. Right then. What sort of Pokemon we can look at out here now? Bug type Pokemon. Certainly matches with a trainer that's just above my head. Bug type trainer. See? String shot. You started attacking me with string shot. Slowing me down, I'm still faster than you. And that means you've only had to do one attack's worth of damage. Strategically, I wouldn't say that was your best move. It wouldn't have helped you either way, but still. Oh yeah, that's a funky pattern here that carries on. No, just battle meter. Normal battle meter now. Bug catcher. Buzzer. Back to battle. So I've got Caterpie. Oh, and it's a strong Caterpie. Soon it'll be a gone Caterpie. Never do anything to me with a string shot. Realistically, I know. If I was being covered in a sticky white string being shot from Caterpie, then yes, I probably would get tangled up quite a lot. It would probably affect my ability to attack it quite a chunk. However, when it comes to the games and its basically stats and numbers, that tends to be a less effective form of attack, really. Venipede, which is Bug Steel, if I remember right, off the top of my head. But apparently a rock type move. That's just me. I really don't want to be using a max potion just for that. Biscuit for biscuit. And right. Ah, that's a shame. First battle of the trainer, dead. Whited out. Because apparently saying blacked out is a bad phrase? I'm not entirely sure on the logic behind that. Why did I go to that point? You get back a full up. Right. In that case, might be time for a bit of training before I raise him again. Thankfully, the next move I learn shouldn't be too far off. And off the top of my head, I believe it's Ember. Nice fire attack, which absolutely wipes out the bug Pokemon, steel Pokemon, bug steel Pokemon in seconds. So here's hoping. It's level 7. I guess it's one more battle. Come on. You can get this one. Wild Bidoof appeared. These guys can be built like tanks if you do them right. Because they're a normal type. They can be particularly annoying. Their only weakness being fighting types. Yay, level 7. Knew it! Yes, Ember. Alright, screw you, bug catcher. Your funky music. Hope always be strong. I'm about to show you how weak they really are. Burn Pokemon. Gone in one. And that's another one gone. No rollouts from you this time. Whoa. Okay. Two levels from a starting trainer. And one Pokemon on a starting trainer, that's not bad. Probably get another one, potentially two levels out of it. Oh, so close. However, I'm pretty sure this cat will be able to take me to the upper level. In fact, I could probably have just killed it with scratch. Point. I've got that many more levels of advantage. Quality battle, I must acknowledge your strength. Just setting fire to your Pokemon, yeah. Yep. No. I admit, I'm completely stronger than you now. I don't believe I have any Pokeballs at the moment. No. No Pokeballs at the moment. Which means only use for going around the grass, it's looking for items. Hallelujah, normal potion. And perhaps grinding my Pokemon to higher levels. Which could be useful. Excuse me. Could be useful, but not something that's going to be too entertaining to watch, really. Gets to the point where I decide I particularly need to do any grinding, I'll probably just speed through it in case I need to any, unless any entertaining bits pop up. Particularly especially as grinding can take a hideously long time. Especially at later levels. A Pidgey. Don't think a Pidgey gets me. Oh, oh. Try. Now are you just electric or electric grass? Green make me think part grass. Yeah, well, either way it's gonna still be a fairly effective attack. Yeah, fairly effective attack. And now it's my question of note, it's just electric. Just like it. Now, I'm going to keep to the attack that's going to keep me at a distance from Mitzel and pretty much any electric type grow. Because occasionally, I'll have an ability that when you touch them, has a chance of an ability called static, I believe, which has a chance or will definitely paralyze you upon contact. So yeah, as I haven't got any cures for paralysis, but I don't tend to have them very often. So. Although, don't have anything to cure it with, and it can be annoying at the best of times. I'm going to try to avoid attacking them. But, at least. Experience can only be gained with time. I think I need to train more. Yes. Yes, you need to train more. Always tell your friend back there not to have a Pokemon that gives such good experience to a Pokemon. Yay! Pokemon in the wild is training. Pokemon is poison, you should use Mastiff for it. Thank you, it was nice of you giving me a Mastiff. I mean, there's a danger of both Pokemon there, it could use a poison attack on me. More likely it's just gonna flap to the ground.